Hello and welcome to our GeoGuessr Daily Challenge. I just woke up.
I did. I woke him up and said, David, quick, I've just come home from the hospital. The doctor's with Andrew. I've got makeup on. I'm looking fairly respectable. Let's do the quiz now before...
She's dragged me into a really freezing cold room.
I went back. I actually knew it was Arab before we saw the language. I could tell by those...
Well done.
Minarets.
Oh.
It's a VIP. So it'll be, what's his name? Qatar.
It is Qatar.
Ugh, he's freezing.
It's so cold.
He's got a blanket over his legs.
I was downstairs wrapped in a lovely blanket and she's dragged me into this room, which is like an iceberg.
Oh, darling. Oh. It's not that bad. My hair's wet.
No, you just have a very low sensitivity to cold.
No, I don't. I have, I'm...
You cannot argue you have a normal sensitivity to heat.
I'm constantly premenstrual and boiling. It's called being a postmenopausal woman.
One day I'll be a postmenopausal woman.
And you'll know what it fucking feels like. Anyway, Rocco, we've got the first fuck out.
Where's the...
It's on the way, because it's the VIP lane for TVs, and this is the VVIP. That's where Jungkook would have gone through. The VVIP. And I just brought in BTS. Now I can tell my BTS story. So in Korea, there's a big drama at the moment because, I have to look at a name, Min Hee Jin is New Jeans, a new girl band.
New Jeans is an old girl band.
Oh, they've been only around about 3 years. Anyhow, she is their director and it's part of HYBE, which BTS are part of HYBE.
How come I can't see the numbers like normal?
I don't care. I'm telling the story about BTS. She has been taken to the cleaner because... She turned up at a press conference in a t-shirt and a baseball cap saying that she's been stressed and they've been picking on her. HYBE's been picking on her because she was trying to get somebody, an international Saudi Arabian conglomerate, to buy all the shares out of her subgroup of HYBE so that she could take over it. And one of the things she did, which was very naughty, she, what's the word, consulted with a shaman. And the shaman said her idea to get her better up in the company was to send all of BTS to the army. So all the army, all the BTS fan club, which is called army, which is confusing when they sent them, are up in arms that she got a shaman's suggestion to send all their beautiful BTS boys off to the army. That's the drama. Are you all interested? David's titivated. Do you know what a shaman is?
Know what a shaman is?
So they do all these
shaman
things
uses
bells.
Totem-based magic.
Oh, okay.
In World of Warcraft.
Oh, and they use bells and jump around, and they wear lots of bright clothes.
Or they use healing-based magic in the board game 5 minutes.
The president of
Dungeon.
South Korea's wife is supposed to talk to shamans too. It's like Ronald Reagan's wife listening to a horoscope.
It's like a psychic, basically.
No, they're a religion. They're a priest.
No, but like
no, shamans are a religion. Shamanism is a religion. We got Brumbies.
Yeah.
So we've got wild horses where I think it could be South America or it could be America, but
I need to drink some tea. My hand's so cold.
I think it's going to be Argentina. Does this give you Top Gear vibes?
Oh, as in like the Patagonia special? Mm. It does a little bit, actually, yeah.
Mm-mm. Is it high?
Car's white, not black, but.
Have a look at that car. Were there wild horses there? Do they have wild horses in South America?
I don't know. We've argued about wild animals before and been wrong.
That was cows. I was right. You were wrong. What's the name of wild horses in Australia? Brumbies.
Broncos.
Broncos are a totally different animal. They're Brumbies.
Oh, I thought they were.
Broncos is the name of the football team.
What's the song about Brumbies? Bring the Brumbies home. Something.
Oh, it's Man from Snowy River.
I've got the song Timey Kangaroo poem. Down Boy
no,
in my head.
Timey Kangaroo Down Sport. No, yeah. There's a poem, The Man from Snowy River, which was made into a big movie starring Sigrid Thornton. And that was The Man from Snowy River, which is the high country in Australia. That's where the snow is. Snowy rivers. And it was all about Brumbies, rounding up Brumbies.
You've told your story. Now I get to tell mine.
Yeah, go on.
About my ridiculous dream that I had like three. Oh, I woke up.
There was a white car that flashed.
Yeah, we're looking for a black car.
Oh, okay. We've got poplar trees and we've got a farm settlement. Okay, we've got a church. We've had this bit before.
We definitely haven't.
This deserted church in a funny little street.
I'm going to take a photo of it for the thumbnail,
bucks we
but...
have. This reminds me of, what's that,
Legally Blonde.
No, David!
Doggy.
Is that a chicken?
That was a doggy.
Oh. where they have a secret club in the...
Oh, no, you know what it reminds me of? And I think you might be right.
It's the church at the end.
This weird bit of Russia.
Really?
Yeah.
But was that church didn't look Orthodox? Have we seen any language? Do they have wild horses in Russia?
They must, because Russian horses came from near Mongolia.
Yeah, okay. So Mongolia. Okay, let's go back and look. Okay, this is language. Nope.
Municipal.
It's Spanish.
Wait, does that say Chile?
No.
It says Chile.
Yeah, so it's South America.
Oh,
God. David, no, we would have got a really low score.
Yeah. Very mountainous, so Patagonia. So we're on the Chile side of Patagonia. Patagonia's further down, I learned the other day.
Yep.
Like in there.
Mm.
Oh, I didn't go far enough down. I didn't go far enough down. I was still scrolling through running out of time.
Very good, David.
We got there in the end.
We didn't do Russia.
Yeah. It looks like
Amsterdam,
Russia.
Amsterdam, 74.
Does it say Amsterdam?
Yes. Amsterdam, 74 kilometers.
Oh.
Luandwa, look at the other ones and you can get some idea of where.
I'm just looking how flat it is. Oh my God, that's
the
biggest
the ocean
mountain
on
in Amsterdam.
Side. No, that's the.
Wouldn't that be the ocean there?
No, that's the dikes. And they've got these big things to stop the flooding.
Don't call them dikes. It's offensive.
Stop being naughty. Hippo, oops, 1. Luandwarden, 73. So they have these big humps before the ocean. So we're on a road on the just next to the ocean.
Oh,
do you believe me?
I do.
Luchenstrand, that's the name of the road, Westerland.
I want to see what number that says. We're definitely in Amsterdam, you're right, because it's yellow number plates too.
N99.
Ooh. Okay, well, we look for a 99. I dreamt last night, because I did all the lighting for Riley's show, I dreamt that I got flown to America with some weird Australian soccer team, and I was asked to do the lighting for the stadium.
Yeah, N99, there it is.
The stadium for the game.
That was one of the things, Hippostrophe.
Yeah.
And what's the other one? Hippostrophe and Luandwarden. We're 1K from that one.
Okay, fine. We'll do some GeoGuessr.
you had to go and you're in a stadium. You had to light it.
Yeah.
Because you have weird dreams.
I have really weird dreams.
Okay, so I think it could be that.
I agree.
No. Go back.
Let me check. We are on N99, but it's not a... We're near the water. We can see the water.
I think it's this part.
I think it's there.
No, just concentrate for 2 seconds. I'm going to fart with excitement.
I'm concentrating.
Look, you haven't got the green bank. See?
Don't look into the green, the colours so
There's
much.
The green bank.
The brink.
And okay. That's what those green banks are.
Is that to the north? Ricketts,
do we find the road?
South.
What was the road called? Get the right.
Wasn't it called Verbian something?
Luchenstrand.
No, that's a lookout there. It's called Westerland.
Westerland.
There's Westerland. Yeah.
So,
unless we're there. No, we're not there. Because look, then there's a bridge.
We'll go up that way.
To the east, there's a bridge. There's our bridge.
So go up further that way then.
No, we're here. We're there.
Are you sure?
Yeah, positive.
Oh,
we got the best score. Told you.
Are we the closest?
We are the closest.
We've done it early. Well done,
Other
David Hayes.
Yeah.
Sydney only got a 4.95.
Anyway, I screwed up the lighting the first night of the soccer game when they played most of the soccer game in the dark.
Did we win?
I don't know who
America's
won.
America's not very good at soccer, so.
I don't know. I just remember going around the stadium buying American snacks. It was really weird.
I really hope. What's the name? Buying food involved. I hope. What's the name? Your Agia Gesser from.
It was nice.
Netherlands watches this one. You better send her a message.
And then I. What's it called?
David, dreams are boring as shit.
From the box, you couldn't see the stadium, so I had to sit in the stands with all the people. And Aiden Savage was there.
Doing what?
Just sitting behind me.
Okay, good.
God, it was a weird dream.
Dreams are the JW organization. Is that Jehovah's
Dreams aren't
Witness?
Boring. I tell my shaman all the time and he loves them.
This shaman was a lady.
I tell my shaman all the time and she loves them.
And they ring bells and dance. Yeah. Okay, Coca-Cola, Mexico.
In South America.
Yeah, but... Oh, La Navidad. It's Christmas. Feliz Navidad.
Da-da-da-da-da.
Sorry, it's Mexico.
I'm warming up a little bit, finally.
Good. I'm getting hot.
There's no wonder you're warming up.
Put it on powerful. Half-built houses. Over there, it looks like some water. Nope, just mountains. Oh, I think could we be in Mexico City? Did you know, I learned from that man that I've been watching the YouTube, Bob 10 or something, he's all about languages?
No iPads during the game.
Oh, shut up. I'm just
No looking. Phones during trivia.
Oh, okay. John Cookie's come on. Sorry, John Cook.
Goodbye, John Cookie.
New Mexico was named before Mexico. Mexico City existed, but Mexico as a country wasn't called Mexico. It was named after Mexico City, And New Mexico, a state of America, was named New Mexico before.
That is interesting.
Yeah, I knew you'd like that. It was all about the origin of all the states of America. And most of them, over 60% of them are Indian or tribal names.
Why is that one house randomly round and bumpy?
Well, it hasn't been rendered on the sides yet. Okay, where does it go?
Where are you going, bus?
No. Condamine? Dorosa? Lasso?
Camel.
Condamine? No. Do you think we're in Mexico? Where's the taxi?
Taxi. Oh, I'm so tired. Just woke up. That's why I'm cold. Stop being blurry, taxi. It's really annoying, the South American taxis write on the side where they are, but they write it in the shape of a number plate, so Google's algorithm blurs it. Oh, you know, the other day, Riley asked me, does Google blur number plates? I said, yes, they definitely do. He was too lazy to go outside and read his mum's number plate while filling out a parking form for her. And so he wanted to go on Google Maps, see if her car was parked there and read her number plate.
And he rang you to find out that information.
I know, we were already on the phone.
I must say, though, I actually wouldn't know my number
plate. My old car, your white car, was 467RJU.
Is that a good thing to tell everybody, that I'm driving around a 4675JU?
Well, you never drive around in it because you steal my car every time.
No, when I go to the beach, there you are. I never use it when I go to Sandy because you tell me I'm not allowed to use it in sand.
Well, that's good. Colombia? It's not Colombia. Ecuador? This is bad. Bolivia? Fuck, I don't know. It was Ecuador. Thank God it didn't move.
Oh, thank God it wasn't Mexico that I kept saying. Wendy was wrong.
It's so...
I'd just like you all to know, Wendy was wrong. Okay. No, there was writing there, David. Go back.
Oh, yeah, but it's boring writing.
It's Russia.
Oh,
we got a trolley cart.
Good thing is we haven't come...
Ukraine.
We haven't come across South Korea, so you can't tell your BTS story.
I've already done it.
Oh, did you?
In Qatar.
I didn't know this. Did you tell your BTS story? I didn't hear. I did hear.
She sang out for 10 minutes.
It was semi-interesting.
Oh, little kids.
Hi, kids.
They're selling watermelon. Yeah, there's it still could be Ukraine.
Is no, I'm
Orthodox
trying to...
Church?
I think I did briefly see a red car. I think it is Ukraine.
Well, that trolley car looks like Ukraine. Did you see it before? I've seen those in Ukraine before.
I've been seeing these TikToks. It is red. It is Ukraine. Of this girl from Ukraine. She's Ukrainian, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
And she's normally...
They're really cute. Look at them.
They are very cute.
Yeah, that's what we had in the 60s in Australia. We're going down this road. She's very cute, the Ukrainian girl on TikTok.
I said that the trolley car's very cute.
Okay, we're saying is cute?
The trolley car.
Yeah.
The girl keeps
asking for help for money for the...
Well, she keeps doing all these, like, what it's like in the war in Ukraine.
Oh.
But she's just an influencer from Los Angeles. I think she's lived in Los Angeles. She is Ukrainian.
But how would she know then?
But I think she's gone on a holiday to Ukraine and she's just taking lots of photos, fancy photos with the soldiers.
Is she kind of like, what's the word, making money off the war?
Well, she's donating things to the army and stuff. Mm. I don't think she's like supporting, but I'm not saying she's doing anything wrong. I'm saying it's a strange contrast to see videos of the war in Ukraine filmed in the style of Los Angeles TikTok influencer.
Yeah.
Like,
okay, we've got 1 minute left and we're going down to the back streets of Ukraine.
One video will go, oh, look at this is the school I used to go to, destroyed house, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, so why
next one will go, her wearing like the silk pajamas
and
sleeping in the underground bunker.
You can buy these, such and such doesn't.
It was really weird.
So tell me, David.
I'll see if I can find her and show you.
But why is she being recommended to you?
Oh, because, oh my God, I guessed the right city.
Mm.
That was a fucking miracle. I was the only person that guessed the right city.
Everybody will say, wonder how David got that. Gold?
No.
Oh!
Well, a few hundred points off.
But
good score. Good score.
Very good score. And we're fifth. Bossman Ken is first. Sahu's second.
You know how it gets recommended to me on TikTok?
And Sydney's fourth. Well done, Sydney.
I watch enough TikTok crap that I get everything recommended at least once.
Oh, God.
What? No, do I kick something? It's like a cup on the floor.
That's not good, David, when you only got underpants on underneath and arse over tip.
Whoa!
Linda Carter was Superwoman's last
Queen,
name.
Queen, King, Is it chess pieces? No.
Desmond Tutu was a bishop, but it's also a shortening for what do you call it? What do they call them in England? You know, that if you got a bad mark, you did a 2-2.
Oh.
You know, a 2.2 is your grade in university. It's a Desmond.
Oh, that's like Cockney slang. You got a Desmond.
Okay, so he was a bishop in South Africa. So he's bishop, king, queen. Are we doing chess?
Carter's also a last name. Gore.
Al Gore was a
president.
He was vice president.
Oh, he was never actually president. Yeah.
And
Jimmy Carter was president.
What other presidents are there?
Bounty, Saloon, Jewel. They're all things in Cowboy.
Yeah, that's good. I think that's good.
They're all things in the Old West.
Yep. Well done. Now, Honey Carter.
Pulling up my blanket.
Jimmy Carter grew peanuts.
He did.
Al Gore, they're both Democrats. That's not Bush. Bridge. Oh, bridge over the River Kwai. Squat. Oh, you bridge, you squat. These are things to do with
exercises.
Crunch,
yeah.
And a dip. That's
workouts.
No, it'll be
exercises, the first word I said. Busy. Yeah. Queen, king. Honey.
So spelling bee, honey bee, queen bee, busy bee.
Well done, Wendy.
And King, Tutu, Carter, and Gore. Oh, Al Gore? Oh, so is it going to be? Oh, it was Jimmy Carter. It was Desmond Tutu. It was Martin Luther King and, Al Gore. Well, they should have had Obama in there. I would have got it better. Yeah, that really annoyed Trump that he didn't get a Nobel Prize.
I think the point is to
make it hard.
Yeah.
Well done.
Bye.
You didn't do too bad there, that one.
No. Bye.